Joining me now in the studio to discuss the Philistines is biblical scholar Dr. Ra'anan Aishla. Dr. Aishla, welcome.
Thank you. Great to be here.
The Philistines get a bad rap in the Bible, and today we associate them with a boorish lack of culture. How did they get this reputation?
Right. Well, the word Philistine in the English language, as referring to someone who's uncultured, actually stems from the 17th century in Germany, where people who saw themselves as cultured referred to people who they saw as uncultured as the ultimate other, as the Philistine. And that relates to the fact that Philistines in the Bible are the ultimate other. Not only are they not Israelites, but they're not even related to Israelites. They're not one of the members of the group of tribes that inhabited most of this area, and most remarkably, they were not circumcised. And the characters in the Bible make a big deal out of this. They call the Philistines the uncircumcised ones, and you remember the story, of course, of Saul asking David to bring him the foreskins of the Philistines.
So in terms of the connection between the Philistines and culture, this reputation was undeserved. They've been unfairly maligned.
Exactly. And in fact, there's a museum in Ashdod here.
It's 12 o'clock.
That's called the Museum of Philistine Culture.
Interesting. Almost an oxymoron.
Exactly.
One of the great mysteries of the ancient world is where the Philistines came from.
Right.
How did they reach this land in the first place?
Well, apparently they came from the Aegean region. This is attested both in the Bible and in the material archaeology and in the inscriptional evidence from Egypt. So the Bible speaks of them as coming from the island of Kaphtor, which has traditionally been understood to mean Crete, but almost certainly is somewhere in the Aegean region.
When did they arrive?
Around the 12th century.
Okay, well, zipping forward,
yeah.
What became of the Philistines? Where did they disappear?
Right, well, they were destroyed by the same processes that destroyed Israelite society, namely Assyrian and Babylonian imperialism. So just as Sennacherib destroyed, just as the Assyrian emperors destroyed the northern kingdom of Israel, and later Nebuchadnezzar destroyed the society of Judah in the south, so the Philistines were also destroyed by these processes. But they didn't reconstitute themselves later in the remarkable way that the Israelites did.
From the word Philistine, we get the word Palestina. From
right.
that Palestine,
right.
and many of the Palestinians claim heritage way back to the Canaanites. Do they claim a cultural, historical connection to the Philistines as well?
Well, I've heard that high-ranking Palestinian officials have claimed that the modern Palestinian Arabs are ethnically related to the Philistines. There is no truth in this whatsoever. There is no ethnic connection between the modern-day Palestinians and the biblical Philistines.
Who, as you say, were a Greek people.
Exactly.
Okay, well, zooming out more generally, in what ways does modern archaeology inform biblical scholarship today?
Well, Aylon, there are so many exciting finds, and they're finding new things all the time. This year, they found a seal belonging to King Hezekiah, the same King Hezekiah mentioned in the Bible, who faced off against Sennacherib of Assyria. In my lifetime, I would say that the most exciting find would be the Tel Danan inscription from northern Israel, which speaks of the house of David as a royal house, and which shows the Israelite-Aramean wars from an Aramean perspective.
So are we increasingly finding that biblical archaeology is validating the biblical narrative or forcing us to reevaluate our understanding of history?
Well, in the case of the Philistines, I think that the two testimonies are pretty compatible, but I think that it's time to abandon this dichotomy between does archaeology prove the Bible or does it disprove the Bible. We need to see, and I think it is being seen, that archaeology and the Bible are two different sources of information. They each have their advantages and they each have their disadvantages, and they can each shed light on the other.
Dr. Aishla, thank you very much.